Tonight, Big Brother makes Muppets of the housemates.
I know the nose is slightly out of proportion.
I think they've done it perfect.
But...
Dear 19, 9:20 a.m. Today, Steve celebrates his birthday. All of the housemates are in the bedroom.
How old are you today, Steve?
41.
Woo! Go on, Steve-o.
Come on, England. Come on, England.
Okay. Okay.
Hey.
What is it?
Oh, wow!
They're set up like us, look.
Check it out. Yeah.
I'm a mole.
Check the monk out.
Is that me?
Yeah, hey! Look at me!
That one's you, OK? Where's Corin?
Oh my god! Oh, is that one me? Oh,
that's Keeper, I think.
Oh, yeah!
That's you. That's you.
Oh, love it.
Oh, that is your hat. That is your exact hat.
Shabby, do you love it?
Woo!
I love it.
Josie, do you have a big nose like me and yours?
Oh, my God.
Do you know what it looks like? Keith Richards.
This is Big Brother. Would all housemates gather on the sofas in the living room?
Oh, I've got a ripping.
Oh, if you're like a child with a rag doll.
Look at mine, it's got nails.
Oh, it's got nails.
Have you seen Sunshine's Muppet with all her sparkly shit all over her?
Are you talking about me? You're just jealous of my hat.
Have you ever heard of a vegan who doesn't eat vegetables?
John, be quiet!
Oh.
Hello, housemates!
Ha ha, housemates!
Chicken's egg here!
Chicken's egg, remember? Ha ha ha!
You are live to the props room, do not swear.
Now, you may not know this, but we love puppets.
Yes, we do. We love them.
Say hello to Puppet Jovan. Hello. Hello. Sigmund, tell them what is happening.
Housemates must talk through their puppets at all times until further notice.
Until further notice.
Yes.
Yes, you must talk through the puppets at all times, regardless of what is going on.
Regardless of what is going on.
Regardless.
Thank you. If you successfully talk through puppets until further notice, you guys can win a birthday party for Steve later today.
Happy birthday, Stevie boy!
Oh, one rule.
You can't
swap puppets. No swapping puppets.
Zig and Zag signing off. Get on with it.
Bye, Dave.
Right, talk through your puppet now. Get your hand in your puppet and every time you speak, move its mouth.
10:19 a.m. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
What's going on down there?
Your boobs are looking bigger today, Josie.
Thanks, John.
That's all right.
Stop it. Stop it.
Bex.
Nathan has come to the diary room.
How are you today?
The house is absolutely full of beans. We're all jumping for joy, living the dream. It's absolutely fantastic. And of course, we've got the England footy this afternoon, so it's, come on, England, come on! So we're all getting really giddy for that. A few cans of lager in the garden. Check out all the ladies sunbathing and whatnot. Cheering on his team. Perfect, big bruv, perfect.
How much of a football fan are you, Nathan?
It's a massive for me, a massive for the country. And it's pretty much the only time that we do unite as one. And hopefully we're going to emulate what we did yesterday. Beating the Germans, so it's going to be excellent all round.
How is Steve enjoying his birthday so far?
I've not seen the big fella smile this much in ages. He's loving it. Of course he's loving it. Everyone's getting involved and bless him, Steve. It's his birthday, 41 today. The big man, it's good to do something nice for him. So we've got to make sure he has the best day he can today. Get plenty of booze in the big old dog and have some nice scran, watch England thrash the Germans and just to generally have fun today. What he says goes today. It's all about Big Steve today. What are you doing down there, you Burke? Did you fret to leave over vegan butter?
No, I just got... I had enough.
You were on that dairy room door like a tramp on a sandwich.
AM. Shabby and Corin are in the bathroom.
Oh, I love it! I'm loving it!
Buzzing! On your own.
Buzzing!
What's Sunshine doing over there, Wizard? Looks like she's trying to add more sparkly shit to her Muppet.
Well, you can stick a few gallon on that nose to start with. She probably need to put some scaffolding around it to get up there.
I think your nose is okay.
Thanks.
It makes you you, and it can be seen.
Look at the snozzer.
You're now
it's nearly bigger than the moles.
Don't listen to them. They're just jealous because you're now a tourist attraction because your nose can be seen from outer space.
I know the nose is slightly out of proportion.
I think they've done it perfect.
But regardless, this is still the best present I have ever had my life.
I think they've got the measurements right down packed.
It's beautiful.
I can't believe they actually found that same crappy dress that she wears every day. I think I can't believe they found a replica of it.
They had to scour the second-hand shops of London, but they managed to get all the one.
I got it from the market, actually.
They needed a little bit of extra material for that nose. Notice how they've given her a bigger mouth than everyone else's?
It's the same size, actually. In fact, yours is bigger.
I don't think so.
Hey, Sunshine.
Big mouth, big nose.
I love how they gave her such a big nose.
That is so funny.
AM. Some of the housemates are in the bathroom.
Are you a real housemate?
Yes.
You swear on our friendship?
I swear on our friendship. I swear.
And you swear on my life?
I swear on your life.
Something going on here, Maul?
No.
Wowee!
Did you just look at my skirt?
No.
Because you know what the word for that is, don't you, Nath? Pervert.
He's a horny little puppet.
I want to get my fluffy hands on Corin's false boobies.
You dirty puppet.
I'm going to have a go in a minute. Oh, yeah, Corin, let's have a go.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you.
Oh, yeah, babe.
Happy birthday, Mr.
Oh, yeah, I can
Stevie.
Feel that, baby.
Happy birthday to you.
Yeah, we're doing babe.
PM. Sunshine has come to the diary room.
Bum 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 ma. Gary my, no we can't read a my poker face. She's gotta love nobody. Da 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 da. Woo!
Some of the housemates are in the garden.
You wish you had heels on, don't you?
Yes.
Mine's got gladiator sandals, just like mine. Me.
John James and Mario are at the sofas.
Do you know what the funniest thing is? Like, I would have sex in here, but I wouldn't masturbate in here. That would just look sad.
Well, sex is easy, isn't it? Because you could sort of... You could do it, it'd be shit.
It'd be over really quick.
And you wouldn't be able to get right into it unless both people wanted to. Is it really worth having sex, like, unless you're going to full bang them?
Slam.
Unless you're going to slam him.
Slam him hard.
Mm.
Big brother, my human clone thinks John James is the most attractive male in the house. But as a puppet sunshine, I don't think puppet John James is as attractive.
Why do you find John James so attractive?
I think he's lovely, and when he's not moaning, he's really nice to talk to and really sweet and kind. He looks a little bit like David Beckham, but then he opens his mouth and he's like, na na na, ra ra ra, ra ra ra, ra ra. What's that to do with my truth? You're a vegan! A vegan and you don't like vegetables. I could never go on a date with you. I'd be like sitting there and I wouldn't be able to eat my food because I'd be like guilty because you're eating like a plate of vegetables. Blah, blah, blah.
PM. Some of the housemates are in the garden.
Corin?
Hmm?
You all right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you want some water?
Mm-mm. No, thank you.
The boobs are licking good.
Thank you.
Coming in a pool bed?
No, I'm fine, darling.
Sunshine, John James and Dave are in the bedroom.
I really like living with boys because it's just, like, easier. Like, they'll be messy and I'll just clean up and do the washing up and stuff, but I don't mind doing that if it means never arguing and stuff, so...
Yeah.
So you should be doing a bit more washing up in you, then?
I do a lot of washing up in here.
I've yet to see you doing any washing up.
Yes, you have.
No, I haven't.
You have.
Haven't.
No, I'm always going around collecting up the glasses and doing the washing up.
I must have missed that day.
Yeah, I must have missed that once she did it.
She probably thinks of clearing up her crisp packets and her pizza box.
She thinks getting the crisps that drilled into her drawer. Yeah. She's what she thinks is cleaning.
So nice to you today, John, in the diary room. I did say that you're the most attractive man in the house.
Well,
apart from me.
Thank you.
You've been sucked in, your sunshine.
For what?
You've got a crush on an Australian. What's the matter with you?
What's
wrong with us British men? What's wrong
with seals? The last guy I was dating had an Australian
accent. I'm pretty good to you, considering you moan a lot. Whinge. Some seem to still get along with you. I don't know how that's working.
You fancy, that's why.
It's mostly food for me.
I've noticed that.
And in the outside world, that's 100% never an issue.
Then why moan?
I don't think it's necessarily moaning. I think I've been more upset than moaning.
You threatened to leave last night because you didn't get your vegan butter.
Did you threaten to leave over vegan butter?
No, I had enough.
You were on that diary room door like a tramp on a sandwich.
And you said, I'm close to leaving.
I just wanted to be treated the same as everybody else. If everybody else gets margarine, they can
You're treated better.
I just want the margarine.
You've got many perks, Beanie.
Yeah, you're treated better than us.
I know I am.
Even though for you it's just normal living, really to other people it would be seen as favouritism and special dietary requirements.
Especially labelling the crisps sunshine.
Sunshine's crisps.
Lay off it, guys, feel better.
You don't take it to heart, though, do you, Sunshine?
She's not talking to us.
Do you, Sunshine? Are you alright, Sunshine?
Yeah.
Ava, are you alright?
We love you a bit.
We love you, really.
We love you.
Are you alright?
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry about it, Sunshine. We're only winding you up. Don't worry about it.
PM. Yep. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Wonder if July's going to be as sunny as this.
What are we in now?
June.
Still?
Yeah, 27th, Steve's birthday.
I thought we were in early in August.
Darling. We've got a, you know, for those people such as yourself who will probably be in here for the long haul, you've got a lot longer to go.
I can't see it, Ben. I just cannot see it.
See what?
Me being in here for the long haul.
Well, why wouldn't you? You irritate absolutely no one. The only person you've had a big argument with is John, and these guys sorted that out. The thing about John is that he's the most wonderful, warm, fun person. He's a lot more neurotic than he thinks he is. So it's like, you know the way he teases me sometimes, like, Benny, why are you getting upset about this? Why are you getting upset? He actually gets more upset about things than any of us.
Yeah.
True.
Yeah.
But you and I can see it in us, but he can't see it in him.
Yeah.
It's like he tells me sometimes, he's like, you're expressionless, you never smile. Well, I'm not one of these people that goes around with a big grin on my face. That is true. And I'm quite, as I said, I'm quite Roger Moore-like in terms of I keep my emotions in a bit. But he's the same. If you actually watch him on the sofas, he pouts most of the time too. He's exactly the same. That's why he likes me. He can see, he sees a lot of himself in me.
I like him. I don't know what it is.
You know, fundamentally, he's a really decent guy. He's fun. Well, also, I think genuinely you're the person he has the most time for. I think he looks up to you.
Me?
Yeah. Because ultimately, and I don't mean this in a bad way, he's quite a lonely person. So he gravitates to people who he thinks are the popular ones.
He's... I don't know, there's something quite special about him. I don't know what it is. I can't put my finger on it, really.
Ooh, he's... I don't think you need to put your finger on it. You like him. That's all that matters.
Are you nude under there?
No.
That in there was killing
me. Got a swimming costume on.
Two or three p.m. Some of the housemates are in the garden.
Do you think you guys have smoked more than usual since you've been in here?
Yeah.
And is that
definitely
out of boredom
or
stress?
I don't smoke more than about 5 to 10 a day usually at home unless I'm drinking.
And how much are you smoking here?
20 to 30 a day, at least.
Well, be careful. You've got good skin. You don't want to lose that.
Oh, well, but some aspects of my health have improved since I've been here because I haven't been able to drink so much. And my diet's actually been better.
Why, just because you have takeaways a lot normally and stuff, or...?
No, because I don't have a house for takeaways to be delivered to. It's because I don't... Well, obviously, I don't have a kitchen, so I can't cook meals or anything.
So what do? You just get things from the street and eat them normally?
I pull them out of bins.
And regarding the bin thing, and I'm interested because I've got a friend that does this too, is it that you target certain supermarkets or...?
Yeah. Yeah, there's usually a supermarket.
What are the best
the
ones? Apparently Asda's good.
I haven't lived near an Asda.
Steve, Nathan and Sunshine are in the bedroom.
Oi Mara, Sunshine's upset.
Why?
Because I think she, the
have
nose...
Have you been a naughty boy?
The nose calls will keep...
Just say sorry to her, then. Give her a cuddle.
Oh, yeah, she's not happy.
Just say sorry and give her a cuddle, and she'll be...
Yeah, we already have, she's not happy. I think she really cut the shits this time. We thought she was just barking around, but I think she was.
Right, let me go.
Should I go and get your trunk specs?
And then we pushed the vegan matter a little bit further, and then, yeah.
I thought in the bedroom you was going a bit far, saying about... Like, the vegan, yeah, but her nose...
But we went to...
Yeah, they're dissing the nose on the dummy.
I seriously don't think she's got a real...
She said she had a massive nose herself.
I seriously didn't think... If I thought that, I wouldn't have taken the piss.
I know that.
But a Muppet does have a big nose. I'm not going to deny that. It keeps poking my eye out every time I go near it. But I seriously don't think she...
Ow.
All right, let me go have a chat with her. Calm her down.
I thought I'd tell you.
Thanks.
She's your best friend.
I'll go chat with her, so excuse me if you...
No, it's fine.
Mario?
Yeah?
You okay?
What do they look
I'm
like?
I'm speak to Sunshine. Come on, go. That grass is hot.
Hello, Danny.
What's up, Steve?
Hello, Mario.
Hey, Steve. Ooh, it's nice and cool in here.
Yeah, it's a bit off the outside, isn't it, now?
Sunshine, it's just me. Right. How many bloody layers have you got? Come on, talk to me. What's up? Hey, don't be like that. What's wrong? Oh.
When they come to the bathroom and talk?
No.
When they go to the kitchen and talk?
No.
When they go to the wardrobe and talk?
Yes.
Come on then.
You go first.
You go first. I don't think we're actually going to fit in it, but...
You have to go in the washroom.
I'll have a quick hand shandy while I'm in there.
Oh, yeah. Cool.
No. Are we actually going to close the doors as well? Ah, are we going to get out of here? What's up?
Nothing. I just wanted to sit in the wardrobe.
Actually, this is the first time I've actually sat in the wardrobe.
It's quite comfy, isn't it?
Well, come on, what's bothering you?
Nothing, they were just like... Like, I don't want to be like... They're making out that I go in going, I want crisps and bread, I want crisps and bread and stuff. When generally, all I'm asking for is soy milk, tofu and vegan butter. And he was like, you get treated better than everybody else, do you not think? And I was like, in the way that they supply for my dietary requirements, yeah.
Why do you let it bother you?
Because he jokes, like, joking about me going to McDonald's and ordering chips and bun is funny. Joking about how little vegetables I eat is funny. But saying that I'm whinge and moan and I always expect loads and that I'm ungrateful and stuff.
They're only joking with you.
He wasn't.
Don't get yourself worked up.
No, I don't want to be dictated. I don't want to be known as the whinging, moaning person. I'm aware I'm moaning now. I'm moaning about being portrayed as a moaning person.
The irony of it. Hello.
Oh, my God, I thought there were other people in the house.
...2:49 PM. Some of the housemates are in the kitchen.
Sunshine.
Yeah?
I promise I will never ever, for the whole time we're in the house together...
Yeah?
...mention your dietary requirements one more time.
Oh, thanks.
Corin is in the diary room.
I absolutely love this doll. I love it. And then, like, I love the fact how it's bright orange and everything. Like, it really makes me laugh. I love it. I love everything. I love the outfit that she's got on, you know, the pink top, the pink bra, which is quite funny, the pink shorts, the flip-flops. I love the nails, I love the eyebrows, the eyelashes, all of it. Like, I love her, I love it.
Thank you for coming to talk to Big Brother, Corin.
Oh, thanks. Like, I would have spoke more, but actually my head is banging now because I'm that hot and I've just come out of the sunlight. My head is banging, sat here like this. Oh.
John James and Josie are in the pool.
Do you reckon Nathan cheated on me?
What's
hanging around with you?
No, what would he be laughing for?
Because I think he likes you, eh?
I don't think he does, it was stupid.
No, I'm not fucking taking the piss, I'm being serious. Like, do you think he's getting a bit shitty?
No. What, is that how you feel?
Yeah, I just felt about a bit like that today, yeah.
How?
No, I just thought maybe he likes you a bit.
No, he don't like me. I'm obviously a bit closer to you than I am Nathan, but I don't think he would be jealous about that.
I think he does like you a lot.
No, I don't. I feel a bit uncomfortable
around
you now.
But I didn't want to come across like that. Because I don't know you, yours and his relationship.
Same as me and you.
He's a little bit more, like, sexual stuff with you, like, do you know what I mean, like...
What?
Well, like, he talks about the way you look and that, I don't... Like, I seriously thought he was a fan.
No. No more of a fan than you are, John James, but yeah.
I'm a big fan.
Thank you very much. Let's face reality, for fuck's sake.
But you don't think you're attractive at all?
I'm just average.
Oh, that's fucking awesome.
Oh. Look at little...
Someone else was taking a piss out of it before.
11:57 p.m. Yesterday, housemates won their penalty shootout task against Big Brother Germany. As a reward, Big Brother has given them football paraphernalia and a live screening of the England versus Germany World Cup match.
I don't mind whether I watch it or not, so I can bring things in and out.
Do you like football?
I do a bit. I've never understood people that... I like watching show jumping on the telly. That's really... No, and I like tennis. I like watching Wimbledon. I like one-on-one things. I don't like watching team sports.
I only like watching skateboarding and motocross. Do we have to watch the football?
No.
Oh, cool.
We do the wash?
No.
Well, if you don't want to watch the football, why don't you go and wash up?
Yeah, no, that's a good idea. I'll do some of that.
Oh, it's Barry as well. They're playing Barry and Joe Cole.
BB.
There was rumours they were going to be playing green, weren't they?
Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. Come on, England!
Come on, England.
Oh. This proves why democracy isn't always right. 80% of the great want to watch the football, 20% don't. But yet we all watch the football. Or we clean.
Yeah. That's a great choice we've been left with there.
Right, I'm going to take this off to fill the saucepan with water.
I'll do the washing up with you.
But I'm not allowed to speak, OK?
Yes. This is going to be a great 90 minutes, I can tell already.
Get on with it, James! Oh, fuck!
Oh, my God, they scored! Who are? The other team!
Tabby, this is boiling water for you. Here. You don't need hot water.
What we can do, when Shabby's on the glasses, I'll do the plates, and then I can use hot water.
I'm just doing the glasses and cold water.
Not the plates.
No! I'm boiling
that water for the plates.
Ify.
I'm going.
Love you.
Just leave,
but
please.
Bugger off. Seriously.
Yes, I want to go
we
anyway.
We do have some skills. Minimal between the three of us, but some.
Good. Well, I hope so.
Bloody hell, it's our kitchen too, Ify. We're looking after it. We're on it. Don't worry.
Fine, I'll leave you to it.
Thank you.
Yeah, please do.
I hope I haven't missed the goal now.
Is there a problem if you did for hanging around the kitchen?
I was coming to make my coffee.
p.m. Housemates have been watching the football for 1 hour and 26 minutes.
Oh, my goodness.
Here we go.
That's bad.
Watch this, you just slot this right in the corner. There it is. Bang.
Oh.
This is disgusting. That's it, Nate, for another one.
Do you want to know? It's 4-1 now. Get lost. Seriously, I'm not even joking. That's shit. Oh, well, annoyed. Does that mean
you get paid how much a year?
Like?
300 grand a year a week.
Stupid amounts. We're just too slow. 4-1? 4-1. Can you believe that? Who got the one? We. I mean, who scored it? Oh, I don't know. Mostly we've got a lad about 21 when we've got 30-year-olds playing. Simple as that, Corin.
Well, at least we beat them in the big bro house. I know it's not quite the same, but it's summer.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I got a hairy ass.
Welcome to the club.
You got what?
Got a hairy ass.
You do?
Yeah, I just realised.
Wax it.
Wax it, bend up. Oh.
5:10 p.m. It's been 21 minutes since Germany knocked England out of the World Cup.
So explain to me, why did England do so badly? Was it because they played badly or Germany did very well? Or a mixture of the two?
Well, Germany did look fitter, sharper, more composed on the ball. Germany kept hitting them on the break and just scoring. 4-1. Absolutely terrible.
John James and Steve are in the living room.
This joint is a fucking pig sore. There's just shit fucking everywhere.
Josie and Iffy are in the pool talking about John James.
I made a right show of myself on the other day.
What did you do?
When they were in the football camp. When you put a football camp, I was like, wow! That's what I was like. It was really embarrassing because, right, I was sitting, say your John is sitting there. I was sitting with him and he happened to, like, he was, like, talking and he happened to look over and I was like that. I think he knew because I think he was really embarrassed about it.
He was well embarrassed.
I had to put my sunglasses on so it wouldn't show that I was staring. And then I just realised, looking at your eyes, that you can see straight through her.
Can you?
Yeah. Oh, shit. Literally, I was like, looking. I bet every time John James did it in this book, I go a bit giddy.
Five fifty-one PM. Most of the housemates are in the garden.
Are you nude under there?
No.
That in there was killing.
Got a swimming costume on.
Are you asthmatic?
I reckon you're a fan. Didn't mean to be a sunshine.
What about sunshine?
Apparently, I'm in love with Jace.
You're
in love with Jace. Yeah. I don't know whether you're in love with Jace or sunshine. It's one or the other.
I don't think he's in love with anyone.
I don't think you can grow hair on your belly button like that and get away with it.
Maybe you're in love with me.
Do you remember last night when you woke up?
At like 3 a.m, you went, I love you, Johnny. I said, I love you too.
Did I?
Yeah.
What did you say?
She goes, good night, John James. Because I came in at like 3 a.m, I said, good night. And she goes, I love you. I said, I love you too.
I can't remember saying it.
It's not so bad, it's because I said I love you too, so whatever happens, I know, at least I know I've just replied.
Thanks for replying like that.
Get in the snug and get busy.
That factor fur is strong, isn't it? Is it sunk in yet?
Well, you can't even see nothing, seriously.
I hate this blue eyeshadow we've got.
I'd seriously tell you.
I'm not a fan of the blue eyeshadow. I don't know why they put blue eyeshadow on me.
It's quite 80s, isn't it, blue eyeshadow?
Yeah. Don't like it.
You associate it with girls in WH Smith.
You ready to find something? I love that face. What have I got? What have I got? Just spit it out. I can't be fucking waiting. What have I got?
Dry lips, really dry lips.
I always get dry lips, don't I?
Yeah.
Dry lips.
I've got.
Oral was too.
Hey, you listen when I speak.
I'm sorry.
I've got lip stuff, but I don't use it. I never ever throw you lip balm or anything. But, yeah.
I bet you're a big good kisser, aren't you, Ben? Because your lips are always moist.
I am a good kisser.
I'm a good kisser.
With these dry chapped lips?
No, I'll go like this. If I can kiss you, I'd go like this first.
You know, I got teased as a child because I had very red lips.
It doesn't take long to like build up moist saliva when you're kissing someone. You know? It takes like 2 seconds.
Obviously, you've had a lot of practice, John, because you're like the Australian serial snogger. I think I got a bit of a, what do you call it when you a fantasy.
Six thirty PM. It's been 16 minutes since the puppet task ended. Ben and Mario are in bed.
How have I annoyed you? What?
Well, you seem to think my interest in extraterrestrials is very weird.
I do find it difficult to understand how people can be interested in something that they have no evidence that exists. There's pretty hard documented evidence that things did or didn't happen.
But maybe that just means you've got a broader mind than I do.
What does it matter?
Of course, because you're my friend. I wouldn't want to offend you. You do a lot for me. Sorry.
That's all right. I just realised you're more narrow-minded than I first thought.
I'm not remotely narrow-minded. I'm not interested in aliens. You can't claim someone's... Aliens. You can't claim someone's narrow-minded because they're not interested in so life.
You don't have to justify yourself.
Shut up, you twit.
You are who you are.
You can't make me look narrow-minded. I'm the one... I defend the indefensible.
Josie has come to the diary room.
I think I got a bit of a... What do you call it when you, A fantasy. I think I like blokes in football kits.
Which of the boys looks best in his football kit?
Nathan and John. Nathan looked like, is it John Terry? The naughty boy. And, John looked like Beckham.
What is it about the footballer look you like?
I don't know what it is. Can't help it. I feel really naughty. I quite like the rugby player look as well. Quite like the soldier look as well. Quite like the navy look. I even quite like the police uniform. Quite nice. Quite like overalls.
You said you feel naughty. Why do you feel naughty?
I don't know what it is. But when they got a football kit on, I just turned into, like, a proper Randy Mayer. And I'm not like that.
It 8:59 p.m.
I think in honour of Steve's...
On the Swamis.
I think in honour of Steve's birthday, we should go around the room and ask him an amusing question that he... Nothing too personal, but anything...
Oh, what?
An amusing...
Not too personal.
Well, no, or personal, but within reason.
Not personal enough.
You start off then, Ben.
No. OK, I'm going to ask...
What, coming from Mr. Personal himself, who won't really answer a question?
No, I'll ask amusing questions. I don't want to be asked about my blood type and stuff. It's so boring.
Oh, gosh.
That's your question, Dave.
OK, so my question to Steve on his birthday is, what was naughtiest or wickedest thing you did as a child?
Probably cut all my sister's doll's hair off.
Had she done something to antagonise you?
Or? No, I did it just because I wanted to.
Oh. And how old do you reckon you'd have been at the time? That's not my question.
Eight?
72.
Yeah. 25. No, that's about 89 years old.
You married? My question, Stephen, is birthday is, how old were you when you lost your virginity? and how did it happen?
Too young, and I'm not going to tell you because I don't know who's watching.
My question to Steve on his birthday is: out of all your tattoos, which means the most to you?
I'd say apart from my children, the bomb, because obviously that's laughing in the face of adversity. So no, I survived, mate.
Now I know that because I've been looking at him for a while.
But yeah, that's the one that means the most.
Okay, my question to Steve on his birthday is. Looking back at your 41 years thus far, what would you, if you had to pick one, what would be the single best kind of, what would be the best moment of your life so far?
The best moment of my life, obviously, is surviving the bomb I was involved in. Second to that is meeting my lady who I'm married to now. I'm highly privileged. I love this woman to bits. You probably don't realise it, but she's given me loads of great kids and that's it.
9:39 p.m. As a reward for passing the pub a task, housemates have been provided with a karaoke party for Steve's birthday.
Oh, no! Wicked! Yeah!
No woman, no cry. Come on, let's sing.
I know this one. Yeah, man.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is it my song?
Yeah.
Keep it, dance to the side so I can see the words, darling. Dance to the side so I can see the words.
Then I remember
where we
used to stay.
Ben and Dave are in the nest.
Everyone are lovely people, but literally, I'm not just saying this to flatter you, apart from you,
There's no one whose company I actively enjoy almost all the time. Joan and me. I mean, Mary is one of my best friends and he's lovely, but he's not particularly witty or funny. Can you actually really remember anything he's said? No, you can't, because he just sort of... he makes little comments about UFOs and things. And Johnny I absolutely love. I'm not as close to John as I am to Mario, but I love John, but John always needs someone else to bounce off. I just can't believe that people don't want to sort of actively discuss things more or laugh more. All people want to talk about are tits and bums and vaginas and... you know, there's just...
It's all the sexual innuendo stuff.
Oh, God, I mean, I like sexual innuendo, but I like it if it's amusing and witty and if it's varied. I don't want to hear about the same things all the bloody time. I'm struggling at the lack of privacy, which, of course, I knew was always a part of this. But it's like, occasionally, I thought, never having seen this programme before, I thought there'd be, like, more reception rooms. So I thought you might have someone that's having a lie-down in some room and then another person who's... I thought that there'd be, like... I know you... I always knew you couldn't have books and music in here, but I thought there'd be, like, little activities that you could do, you know, a jigsaw, a game of cards or something like that, but...
We better go up, because it's the Baron's birthday, isn't there? And,
yeah, two minutes.
Yeah, we better go up, come on. Right. It's his birthday, and I don't want him thinking that we've ditched out on him on his birthday. That's the last thing we need, the Baron's birthday today, and a gold ring.
Yeah, we don't want a rift between us and the Baron.
Everything's gonna be all right now. Everything's gonna be all right.
...10:14 PM. Sunshine, Shabby and Corin are at the carousel.
I'm thinking, so Shabby, disgusting. About this being my eviction wig.
No.
No way, Sunshine.
Why?
Because you're actually really pretty and you should have your hair, which... your real hair, which, you know, is a good thing for
Watch
your look.
Watch what you're saying.
I'm saying good things.
No, with my hair.
No, but for her, her
there
real
is
hair
no,
looks
there's
better
nothing
than that
better than the natural
wig.
Thing.
That wig's minging.
I love it.
It's minging.
When I saw it, I was like, oh my gosh, Chelsea, this is a wig.
It makes do you want to know? It makes you look older. That's not
a
good thing.
Yeah, I think it is a bit Deirdre Bauer looking.
Yeah.
Kiva, Josie and Nathan are in the diary room.
Right, we've got a proposition for you, big guy.
Do you want to sit up here?
I'll perch up here, yeah? I want... Oh, that's a bit... Oh, nice and tight there. Right, I'm just here with my main girls here. Right, we've got a proposition for you. We'll swap you this half-eaten birthday cake with one half-burnt-out candle for some tobacco and some alcohol. Right, what do you say to that, big guy?
It's a deal. It's a seal.
It's the sale of the fucking century.
Need some tobacco.
I just like
such
a bit of...
delicate flowers wilted.
I just like a bit of rosé, well, if I got to be honest.
I can make your cheeks rosé.
No, you naughty boy.
So what are you saying, Buffskis? Have we got a deal? Share this between
cake.
The camera dudes.
Cake?
Have your cake and eat it. And nip that 24-hour garage first, please, mate. And can I have a copy of Mayfair magazine as well, please?
How are housemates enjoying Steve's birthday?
Oh, we're loving it.
Yeah, apart from my
we're loving it
too much.
I'm buzzing.
I'm having such a great time. It's such a privilege to be here, to be around such good friends. And but the only thing we're lacking is, bruvskis, we need some more booze. We want to get to know each other.
And we need some tobacco.
On the outside and also on the inside. Please. And there'd be no snoggy snoggies without no boozy boozy.
Oh.
Night. 10:25 PM.
I'm feeling a monster, cause nobody wants to see much no more. They want shitty, I'm chopped liver. Well, if you want shitty, this is what I'll give you. A little bit of me, me, so somehow they can talk. They can talk, so I get you that lot of the dough. But I'm gonna run a lot of rain. When I'm rocking in the day, what is up with rain? When this song is not a thing, cause I'm back, I'm a bragging on the lady.
And when you let the love scene, you bring your heart to that one. Come to it, come to the lips, come to the lips.
One of the tears to get ready. This is back in heavy, I had to settle my lawsuit. Fuck you, Daddy!
AM. Some of the housemates are in the bedroom.
Keep it down, guys.
You should ever shut your mind, don't you? Ever shut your mind. Going on and on and on.
Steve, Sunshine, Dave, and Mario are in the living room.
Right, I'm going to get to bed.
Love you, man. See you tomorrow.
Have a good night's sleep.
Thank you, David. Oh, it's not good for my spine.
Sunshine, that's how precious, Sunshine.
I'll see
you guys tomorrow.
This would be a good task, to be like, hug Mario for the whole day without him knowing what you're doing.
Whatever could you be doing?
Well, it won't take long, did it, mate?
Oh, guys, you had a good birthday. Good, Mario.
They don't want to tell me how the toilet works.
It was excellent, mate.
When will I see you again?
Tomorrow, or it's like in a few minutes, if you go to bed. Good night, Steve.
Good night, darling.
Birthday. Did you have a good birthday?
I've had a great birthday, shall we tell you?
Yeah.
That's great.
Probably had more lager than anyone else. You probably did well on the lager.
Yeah, I did well. It's good. Tell you what, sometimes I still can't believe I'm in here. I don't know why.
Yeah, it's pretty surreal, isn't it?
Mm. Yeah. Very surreal.
I think I'm going to have a poop.
See if you can do that, mate.
Hmm?
Let's see if you can do that for me.
I'm going to bed.
Tomorrow's nominations day.
Everything he talks about seems to be about, like, sex, bums, bars, nipples. Sick of hearing about it.
For more news on today's nominations, head to channel4.com/bigbrother.
A child's badly wounded in a drive-by shooting in brand new cop drama Southland. The OC Benjamin's Mackenzie stars on More 4 this Thursday night at 10. Well, next here on Channel 4, life on the road isn't too quiet and peaceful either, with N-dubs.